गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स. येस्टरडे आई टॉट यू टू प्रूव दैट इंक्रीज्ड विंड स्पीड रिड्यूस्ड एयर प्रेशर. येस्टरडे आई टॉट यू टू प्रूव दैट इंक्रीज्ड विंड स्पीड रिड्यूसेस एयर प्रेशर. एंड टुडे आई विल टीच यू एयर एक्सपेंस ऑन हीटिंग एंड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स ऑन कूलिंग. टुडे आई विल टीच यू एयर एक्सपेंस ऑन हीटिंग एंड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स ऑन cooling. So let us perform the following activities given on page number 82. So first activity 8.4, and take a boiling tube and an uninflated balloon. Blow air in the balloon and remove the air. After that, first blow air in the balloon, then remove the air. Now fix this balloon on the mouth of a boiling tube tightly. Then further secure the balloon with a sticking tape so as to make it more tight. Place the boiling tube in a beaker and then pure boiling hot water in the beaker and observe changes taking place in the shape of balloon. Take out the boiling tube from the beaker and allow it to cool to the room temperature. Observe changes taking place in the shape of balloon. Place the boiling tube in a beaker containing ice cold water. Place the boiling tube in a beaker containing ice cold water. You will notice that when the boiling tube is placed in the boiling hot water, The volume of balloon increases, and when this tube was allowed to cool down, the volume of it decreases at room temperature. On further cooling, the volume of balloon decreases further. So by this activity, it is proved that air expands on heating and contracts on cooling. So by this activity, it is proved that air expands on heating and contracts on cooling. So in this, it is activity 8.4. It is given on page number 82. This is the activity. Air expands on heating and contracts on cooling. This is the activity 8.4, and this activity you can see, and then now. Hot air rises upward and the cold air sinks down. Next, 8.5, hot air rises upwards and cold air sinks down. We have learned that air expands on heating in activity 8.4. When the air expands in the balloon, it means remains same. But its mass remains same, but volume increases. This in turn results in lower density of air. Why it is like that? Due to the lower density of air, as density is the ratio of mass and volume. What is the density? Density is the ratio of mass and volume. In simple words, we can say that hot air is lighter than the cold air and hence rises upwards. Conversely, we can say that cold air is heavier than the hot air and hence sinks down. Following examples will prove that hot air rises upward. In this we will see that hot air rises upwards and cold air sinks down. So we will learn about the first activity. When we burn a heap of dry leaves or grasses or paper, the smoke rises upward. Yes, we can see in that case the smoke rises upward because it is lighter, and now the smoke consists of suspended particles, and now the smoke consists of suspended particles of carbon in air. Therefore, we can say that hot air is lighter. So we can say that hot air is lighter and hence rises upward. So by this activity, it is proved that hot air is lighter and hence rises upward. And on festival like Diwali, people light hot air balloons which rises high in the sky. These balloons are made from bamboo sticks and very light tissue papers. In the middle of this balloon is placed an earthen oil lamp. On burning the lamp, hot air is produced, which is much lighter than the cold air outside. Thus, the balloon rises up in the sky. Similarly, much bigger hot air balloons are used for sport in Western countries. In these balloons, the hot air is produced by a big kerosene oil burner. They are capable of carrying two or more persons. So these are the example of the hot air rises upwards and cold air sinks down. So in this activity, we seen that means hot air rises upwards and the cold air sinks down. And now next topic is the formation of winds due to uneven heating of earth. Moving air, we know that moving air is called the wind. You can feel it on the ground and high up in the atmosphere. The wind can highly destructive. If it blows too hard, it can also do useful work for us. It can move power sailing ships, windmills and modern electric generators, aerogenerators. We know that moving air is called the wind, and you can feel it on the ground and high up in the atmosphere. The wind can be highly destructive. When it is blown very hard or very high speed, then it is very destructive. It destroys houses and plants life, animals life, etc. And it can also do useful works for us also. It can move power sailing ships, windmills and modern electric generators. Now the question arises here, how is wind or winds caused? Basically all kinds of winds are caused due to the uneven heating of the earth. Two important situations are discussed below. First one is the uneven heating due to shape of earth and its inclination. The earth is almost a round sphere. We know that earth is round in shape, inclined at an angle 23.5 degree to its path around the sun. And due to this, the region in the equatorial regions receive more amount of heat than the region near the poles. Thus, the air around equatorial regions expands and rises up. To take its place, the air from the colder region starts blowing towards equator, thereby producing a wind. So it is expected the air in northern hemisphere should move from north to south, and in southern hemisphere from south to north. In this does not happen on account of rotation of earth from west to east. So the air in northern regions blows in southwest direction and in the southern hemisphere in the northwest direction. And now second one is the uneven heating of land and sea. The earth gets five times hotter as compared to seawater on receiving the same amount of heat. You have already learnt about the land and the sea breeze in chapter 4th. These are called the local winds. Similar winds on a much larger scale are formed when we think of much bigger land masses and the sea oceans surrounding them. Let us take the example of India, which is a huge land mass between the Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal. In summer, the months of May and June, the sun shines equally on water. And land mass. However, the land mass India gets very hot as compared to water around it. The air above India gets hot, becomes light and rises upwards. This results in the drop of pressure. Thus, the cold air laden with moisture from the Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal starts blowing towards Indian land mass. This continues for the month of July and August. And it causes a lot of rains all over India. This wind cycle is called monsoon. The word monsoon is derived from the Arabic word that is the mausam, which means season. Monsoon is lifeline for the Indian subcontinent. It provides us plenty of water for agricultural activities.